Hello friends of the Northern Entertainment and welcome to another episode of my Spin Tires Let's Play. Today, really exciting news. If you are subscribed to the subscribed to the beta version of the game, to the public beta, then you might have seen that already. If you are not, then really exciting news because maps are now natively supported. They will be supported with the next public release for everybody, but for right now, if you are part of the beta program, which you can just sign up to in Steam, then you can already start custom maps. And that said, we are going to start today on the Volcano 2016 map, which you might remember that was one of the official maps back then. Or not of the official maps, but was one of the really, well-acclaimed mod maps. But so this is a certified mod. And in terms of trucks, with the uncertified mods, we have the UAZ-302, the YAZ-214, and the MAZ-200B in terms of mods, which is all around the same era, around the 60s Cold War era. And I wanted to start a game with this mod pack for a long time. I suggested that to several others. Nobody took me up on it because everybody is busy. So I am going ahead here and plow through the mud alone. We're gonna start a new game hardcore and we're gonna see. The episodes will be around 20 to 25 minutes long. And we'll see how well you guys like them. So here you see my start lineup. I do really like those. Let's have a quick look here and come up with a plan. So I'm thinking our first plan of action is going to be to unlock the watch points. There's a fuel station, a lock kiosk, one watch point. Another fuel station, another watch point, another garage. And the lumber mill. Is there just one? Yeah, there's just one lumber mill that we have to deliver to, so that's fairly easy. So I think, we're gonna go ahead here. We're gonna go this way around. And we're gonna unlock the watch point here, and we're gonna transport some garage points up there while we're at it. That shall be the plan of action. And I wanna take this little guy here. The UAZ, and let's see what we can take here. Garage points. Oh, that's gonna be fun. How in the... That's funny. This is for garage... That's... Okay, is required to install Lewis garage. That's 1 point, that's 2 points. Nope. There. That is too funny. Oh yeah, alright. Let's see how this is gonna turn out. So we don't have all wheels, we don't have a diff lock. Oh, that's gonna be good. That is going to be something else. I mean, this thing is light and nimble, so that might be actually what will be our saving grace. I hope. Either that or we're gonna be... The thing almost uses no fuel either. This is amazing. But yeah, I always wanted to do a let's... or a playthrough of a map with ever since I seen those packs, I was like, yeah, it has to be done. It has to be done. Alright. So far, so good. This thing is really so light that it doesn't really sink. Don't sink. Don't sink. That is a huge jack in the back. Oh, this is easy so far. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Okay, where we are, where? Wow, we're making already good headway. So there and there, and then we're gonna go to this watch point. And then we're gonna deliver the garage points and go to this watch point. At this rate, we're gonna be through the map in no time. At all. Oh no. I spoke too soon. I spoke too soon. I love this model though. This is great. This thing is going well. It's really, just like I said, it's so light that it doesn't really sink in, and then it has the dualies on the back, which helps further. So it really doesn't need much of a of all wheel and whatnot. The only thing is, you have to kind of pre-plan your route, because you cannot go through... No! No! Actually... Well then. Fire extinguisher. What? Oh, up there. That is cool. Carriage high. Backup fuel tank. Maybe not a bad thing to have either. Oh, this thing carries 4 garage points. Well. Well, our new plan is... Alright, I love... I absolutely love the sounds of those engines. Oh, look at the oh, I wish that cockpit would actually work. This is one of the nicest... this is one of the nicest cockpits that I've ever seen. Oh boy. Well, this whole thing just went from, oh, this is way too easy, to, oh my goodness, it's impossible. Refueled. Yay. All right. I don't know, friends. I don't know. I guess we'll see how this all turns out now. Stay nicely here in the middle. Stuck in the middle with you. Yeah, I love the cockpit though. I wish there was a support for that. And I do hope that they will eventually have support for a cockpit like that. Because it just shows that it's possible. It's doable. Without a problem. I enjoy this mod. And the links to the mod or to the Steam Workshop mods will be in the description below. I promise you guys, I will put it in there. I'm not bothering about the mod spreadsheet per se. My mods can update that, but it will be in the description below. I'm gonna make a great effort to get this done for you guys. Dangerous water levels. Oh, good. Come on, you can do it. You can do it. Yeah. Only 300 meters to go. All right, here we go. And guys, let me know what mods you would like to see next. Because there is a plethora of mods. Alright, we are making great progress. Well, or so I thought anyway. Now it should be lifting out here right away. It's not that crazy bogged down. Yep, there you go. There we go. That's what I am talking about. And see, because those are old engines with very little horsepower, these engines are a lot more efficient overall. And by the way, if you guys are wondering, see this little triangle on the roof? The only reason I know that is because when my dad started trucking, well, it was pretty much on trucks like this. Western trucks, so it was Mercedes and whatnot, not Russian trucks, obviously, but it was all the same back in the day, in the 60s and 50s. This triangle signified that you were able to pull a trailer with this vehicle. So, yeah, just a little bit of information here. Oh, look. I don't know if we should try this. We should be a little bit smarter here and should be going this route. And then we're just gonna flip him back on its wheels. No, please don't. I thought for sure we're gonna put the next one in the ditch here. I would have cried. I swear to you, I would have cried. Let's drag him over. Oh no. We're gonna pull. Hopefully we're not gonna pull us over. Oh yeah, good. Now we got him completely on its side. That's good. Perfect. Add-ons, left or right or what? Oh, that's good. Very cool. Oh, that is too cool. Okay, anyway, stop playing with this. And see to it that we can get going here. Huh. Well, friends. Now, the next thing that I'm hoping for is that we will see... that we will see multi-winching, where I can hook up one winch to one vehicle and then hook up the next winch to the next vehicle, if you know what I mean. No, switch to pull. That should put it back on its wheels. Oh, so close. Oh, so close. For a second there, I thought you actually see oil shimmering on the water. That would have been amazing. I mean, that would have been really sad because you don't want oil in the water, but that would have been amazing. Okay, Houston, we have a smallish problem. But look at, it does really look like there's oil on the water. Oil on the water. Da 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 da. Come on, you can do it. You can do it. So far this wasn't much of a pain and agony simulator though. Okay, come on. Come on. Please me, oh yeah. Period music too. Apologize for my terrible singing. There we go. A quick release for the winch would be nice. Oh boy. Come on, you can do it. And thus, Pain and Agony Simulator once again. Okay, very, very, very slowly we're gonna introduce throttle and hopefully it lifts. Come on. Yes, here is a lot of grippage that we can get here. And not a lot of slippage. Ha ha. The wrong one. There. Courtesy of Streamlabs. No ad, no sponsor. Come on. Oh, come on. You can do it. I know you can. About all that now. I guess I have to do this. I kinda would have liked to at least unlock one point. Maybe not. Yep, that'll do. That'll do, Pig, that'll do. We come later with a smaller truck and... Alright, let's see. Maybe we can flip him now. Although we might be already too far gone. Nope. We are able to do this. Switch to pull, park and brake on. Boop. There we go. See? I'm almost thinking that's a good way to end this. How far? It's only 17 meters to the next... Yeah, come on. Just go to the next. Come on. Okay. That's not gonna work. All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, great progress was made already. Not really, but we'll just go with that. This is a fairly light truck, so we're just gonna nimble as it is. We're just gonna take it here into the forest, but I think... Once we got through... Oh no. That might have been a mistake. That might have been a crucial mistake. Hmm. Maybe. Maybe not. Careful there. Careful, dear. Whoa. Oh man, look at this. Look at how the springs and everything. It's just great. And keep in mind, this is before the era of... This is long before the era of any kind of air ride. Where is the watch point? Oh. Oh boy. It's a while yet. So, I think this is as good a point as any to end this for today. I do hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, hit that like button, leave me a comment down below if you feel inclined to do so. Until next time, this is the Northern Alex signing off. Thanks for watching, and God bless.